Welcome to SBMT's East Studio Cinema Spotlight. I'm Michael Paul Hirsch, chairperson for South Bay Musical Theater and your host for tonight's feature film. This aptly named 1946 film, Swing Parade of 1946, takes us back to a time when movie theaters were filled with patrons yearning to see the top movie stars of their day sing and dance their way across the silver screen. This was the era of Bing Crosby, Gary Cooper, Ingrid Bergman, Fred Astaire, Dorothy L'Amour, Humphrey Bogart, and the Three Stooges? Yes, Swing Parade of 1946 features this comedy trio in supporting roles, inserting their signature slapstick comedy into a story of a budding singer, Carol Lawrence, looking for her big shot, and the nightclub owner, Danny Warren, who might be able to make it happen. It's not quite that simple. What if Danny falls in love with Carol, that aspiring singer? And what if Danny, the nightclub owner, has a rich father who has different ideas for his son? And what if you throw the Three Stooges' wacky hijinks into that mix? So the film by Monogram Pictures features many wonderful performances. Gale Storm, who plays Carol Lawrence, starred in more than three dozen films for Monogram Pictures. You'll love her rendition of Sunny Side of the Street and her reactions to co-star Phil Regan, who plays Danny Warren, standing beside her, singing directly into her ear during one of their lovely duets. Also featured is Connie Boswell, who is known as one of the greatest female jazz vocalists. Connie sang in the style of Mammy Smith, the first lady of blues and the first African-American female performer to make a vocal blues recording 100 years ago with Crazy Blues. Mammy influenced Connie, who in turn was a great influence on Ella Fitzgerald. You'll see in the film that Connie is always singing in a seated position or not moving on the stage. This is because she has a disability and was unable to walk. 1946 was not a terribly friendly time to those with disabilities, but you'll see how they try to conceal it in the film rather than try to simply normalize it. But other highlights in the film include Louis Jordan, the big band swing jazz singer, saxophonist, band leader, known as the grandfather of rock and roll. He appears in several numbers, but I love Caledonia, the neon instrument jazz scene. You'll see. Doris Humphreys, who toured with Louis Jordan, also appears in the scene doing some lovely choreography with Louis. I also adore Windy Cook's attempt to show his special talents to Mr. Moose, sawing a piece of wood. Of course, there are the Three Stooges. Now, if you're not familiar with this comedy team, this may not be the best example of their work, but you'll get a feel for it. They originally started out as a duo vaudeville act in the 1920s with Moe Howard and Ted Healy, then expanded to include Moe's brother Shemp Howard and eventually Larry Fine. They really came into their own after Shemp left the group and his younger brother Jerome Curly Howard joined. They then left Ted Healy, became the Three Stooges, and signed to do short films with Columbia Pictures. Their appearance in Swing Parade of 1946 was kind of on the downward slope of the pinnacle of their popularity. This film was directed by Phil Carlson, and it's only 74 minutes long, but it's jam-packed with lovely singing, comedy, and musical numbers that will please all of you musical theater enthusiasts patiently waiting to return to live in-person performances. So I hope this will whet your appetite until then. And remember, there's only one defense for the two-fingered eye poke. You know? Enjoy.
Serenade, it's a rhythm cavalcade. Here they to sneak out.
Oh, no. I thought maybe you were asleep and
asleep,
I didn't
Asleep,
wanna...
indeed. You owe me 4 weeks back rent.
I'm sure I'll be able to pay you very soon now. I have some good prospects.
Prospects? You do better getting yourself a job in a department store or as a waitress and stop hanging around radio stations and nightclubs.
But you told me I could stay until
Well, I've changed my mind. And you better get my money by tonight.
Start worrying about the mule going blind. Just sit tight and hold that line. Don't worry about the cow being poor. Just drink that milk and ask for more. Don't you worry about that mule, 'cause he ain't going blind. Don't you worry about that mule, baby, you just hold that line. Don't you worry about that mule, 'cause you know he ain't no fool. Don't you worry about that mule, mama, you just keep cool. Some flying high and some flying low, somebody's got to go. You know that he know that she know that they know. Baby, you better take it slow. Don't you worry about that mule, 'cause the mule ain't going blind. Don't you worry about that mule, baby, you just keep cool.
If I were you, I wouldn't go in there, lady.
Better listen to me and take it slow. Don't you worry about that mule, 'cause the mule ain't going blind. The mule's been to school, he ain't no fool. So sit on your stool and don't worry about the mule.
Okay, Louie, that's for me.
Thank you, Mr. Warren, thank you.
Were you looking for someone?
I'd like to see Mr. Warren.
I thought so, out.
But I'm a singer. I just graduated from the conservatory.
Very interesting, and I suppose you got the papers to prove it.
Well, yes.
Come on your way, sister. Save those somewhere else. Oh, these have come to a pretty pass when it's fun. Who is that, Moose? Another one of those process servers.
You sure?
Am I sure? I tricked him into showing me the papers. I'm an attorney, not a publicity man.
Yes, you are the attorney for National Utilities at the present. But if you can't attend to a simple detail like serving a dispossess notice, I'll see to it that the board of directors...
Yes, Dan, I know.
Well, then do something about it.
Dan, he's your son. I never met the boy.
Oh, stop arguing with me. It's exactly because he is my son. I don't want him to open up that or any other nightclub. And stop pacing. I want my son to carry on after me.
I know.
This sort of thing reflects on me and the company. Makes it appear as if we were frivolous people.
I've done all I can. It isn't easy.
We've bought the property. I want him dispossessed. Then maybe I can bring him to his senses. Back to the company.
Now, Dan, he's being very smart. My men tell me that he sleeps in his office, has his meals sent in, and has a strong-arm guard at every inn.
Oh, more excuses. I want some results. I want them now.
You'll get them. Yes? Any luck?
Yeah, it was all bad. Listen to me, Mr. Bascom. 8 times a day I tried to serve this, and 8 times I was thrown out. Now, my wife and kids think I'm a nice guy. But here, you serve me yourself.
You know, Dan, there's a lot of money in the nightclub business today.
Stop pacing.
Oh, yes, Dan, sorry. What do you want?
Did you advertise for a receptionist?
Oh, yes, of course, but see me later in the afternoon, please.
Just a minute. Young lady, do you really want a job?
Yes, I do. I do very much.
She's rather presentable, isn't she?
Oh, yes. Quite presentable indeed.
Nice of you to say so.
It's quite possible that we might engage you, Miss...
Lawrence.
When I say presentable, I also mean...
Oh.
Young lady, do you know where the Embassy Club is?
I certainly do. I was just over there looking for a job. I think whoever owns it must be crazy.
We own it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, you don't get the point. We do not want that nightclub to open.
This is a dispossess notice. Deliver that to Danny Warren, and I'll give you
$50. $50? Gentlemen, it will be a pleasure.
That, my friend, is how I get things done.
It's still a shade too fast, Willie. Will you please try it like this now? Well, Will, go take a few minutes rest and we'll tackle a finale later.
Thanks, Danny. Okay, boys, take 5.
Where are the boys?
In the kitchen.
Go see how they're doing, would you, please?
Okay, boss.
Well, gentlemen, I see you have really settled down to business.
We didn't do it, officer.
It's a lie.
We'll go quietly.
The dishes! Now!
The lug. But don't let them upset you, boys. This club is going to be a great financial success.
Not only that, but we'll make some money, too.
Yeah, then we can retire.
Danny's a great guy. And we got to do everything right to help him.
You said it.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Looking for somebody, sister?
Yes. Mr. Danny, well, you see, I'm a singer and I'd like to try out for a job.
Well, just go around front and ask for Mr. Danny Warren.
Well, I did, but there's a big... I mean, the door's locked.
Oh, yeah, we keep it locked on account of process servers.
Oh. Well, I wouldn't know about that, but I do know that I need a job very badly. I'm broke and...
Okay, sis. We'll help you. Right this way.
Mr. Warren will be in there.
Yeah, he'll listen to you sing.
Oh, thanks. You just don't know what you're doing.
Ah, oh, that's nothing. And something tells me you got something from Mr. Warren, too.
Yes, I have.
Time is a thing which we haven't. Do I make myself clear? And what are you waiting for, Dreamboat? An engraved invitation?
Oh, you mean me?
Well, I don't mean your Uncle Herbert. What's the idea coming your dress? Come on, off with that hat and coat.
But...
No buts, please, no buts. Look at her. She comes all wrapped up like a broken arm. All right, girls, get in line.
But I want to see Mr. Warren.
You don't have to see Mr. Warren. If I will okay you, he will be well pleased. Now let's see you do a time step. And where's your rehearsal clothes?
I didn't bring any.
You didn't bring any rehearsal clothes? And expect me to give you a job, eh? Little music for the Countess. Oh, hit it. Hold it. Now, what is wrong?
I have a loose heel.
What is this, a rib? Who sent you over here all dressed up like Mrs. Astor's pet horse? What are you trying to do, drive me nuts?
This is all a mistake.
It's a mistake, all right, and you're making it, sister. Now, get out of here. Get out of here.
Please.
Get out of here before I lose my temper. Get out. Out.
Careful now.
Madhouse.
What happened?
That man in there.
Never mind that lug. I told you to see the boss.
Thanks, but I've had just about all of this place I can stand.
Say, what's going on in here?
It's okay, Danny.
Are you Danny Warren?
That's right.
Blair!
A process server. Wise guy.
There, go get that girl. We're busy.
You heard me. Drop everything and go get it.
Get all wrong.
How do you like that? Too scared to ask for a job, so she tells me by handing me her eviction papers.
Locked out of a room, bag and baggage, eh?
No home. You know that's tough. But we're gonna do something about it, Moose.
Please let me
Looks
go.
Looks like
let
we're gonna get a chance
go.
Right
let
now.
Me go.
Oh, we used to do piano.
Oh, I've never been so humiliated in all my life.
Here she is, boss. Watch out. She's a little wild.
I'm sorry we had to do it like this, but I wanted to talk.
Oh, you did? Well, Mr. Caveman, you're just a few hundred years late. They don't drag women around anymore.
Well, I'm sorry, but you'll have to forgive the boys. They're a bit impetuous.
Well,
careful. There's a lady here.
Well, now that you've got me, what are you going to do? Well,
what would you suggest?
Oh, letting me name my own torture.
You're a funny kid. You come in here and hand me your own eviction notice, and now you're treating me as though I was tearing you apart.
Eviction notice?
Yes. Why didn't you tell me about it?
Well, I didn't...
Well, Moose here tells me that you're in this morning looking for an audition.
Yeah.
Would you still like to try?
I'd love to.
Okay, go on over to see Eddie. He'll take good care of you.
Dishes.
Can you play Sunny Side of the Street?
Yeah, what key?
Key of F. Oh, pardon me.
Talked with no one and talked with no one, and I had nothing but shadows. Then one morning you passed, and I brightened at last. Now I greet the day and complete the day with the sun in my heart. All my worry blew away when you taught me how to say. Grab your coat and get your hat, leave your worry on the doorstep. Just direct your feet on the sunny side of the street. You hear a bitter part, and that happy tune is your step. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street. I used to walk in the shade with my blues on parade, but now I'm not afraid. This rover crossed over. If I never Rockefeller, gold dust at my feet, on the sunny side of the street.
Thank you. Was it all right?
Of course you were all right, honey. Well, don't keep the girl standing there. Say something.
Oh, hello, Marie.
Not bad at all. I'm quite sure I can find a spot for you in the show.
Oh, thank you.
Well, kid, you're in.
First discovery.
Excuse me, will you please? I'd like to talk to you. We're going over there, and if you'd like to hear what we say, you can all come and sit in our lap.
I'll see that you get a typewritten transcript of the conversation.
But we can't read.
The dishes.
May I take this?
Thank you.
Now, Miss...
Lawrence. Carol Lawrence.
Carol Lawrence. What a lovely name.
I'm glad you like it.
Carol Lawrence.
You did want to talk to me, didn't you, Mr. Warren?
I did? Oh, I mean, I did, yes.
Are you all right?
Oh, I'm fine. Are you all right?
Oh, I'm great. What did you want to talk to me about?
Well, I'll tell you the truth. I have a lot of things I'd like to talk over with you, but it's so noisy in here now. If you were to have dinner with me tonight, why... Oh, please, Miss Lawrence, don't get me wrong. After all, there are a lot of things I must discuss with you. Your songs and the routine and...
I think I'm getting the routine now.
Well, of course, if you don't want to have dinner with me.
I didn't say I didn't want to.
Oh, well, that's fine. I'll have Moose make all the arrangements right away.
Oh, I forgot. They kept my clothes.
Oh, I wouldn't worry about that. Oh, Moose! Moose, two things. First, to have a dinner date.
Sure you have, with Marie.
Oh, brother, I forgot all about that. Well, I'll get out of that somehow. This is more important. The kid over here,
What kid?
The lady, Miss Lawrence. Look, will you go fix a bed up around the Davenport in my office?
Right.
Or look, Moose, you better get her a pair of my pajamas. They not only locked her out of her room, but they also kept her clothes.
Okay, boss. You know, it's things like that that make you think it's an unfriendly world.
Marie.
Oh, Danny, ready?
Oh, Marie, I'm sorry, but I won't be able to have dinner with you after all.
No?
Well, something's come up regarding this
show. What you're trying to say is you want out of our date because you've made a date with the new girl, isn't it?
Well, sort of.
Okay, it's a deal. If Will Osborne isn't doing anything.
Why, Will?
Silly boy.
Thanks a lot, Marie, and I'll try to fix it up with Will.
Pardon me, Pete.
Willie, can I speak to you?
Pal, I want you to...
No.
Oh, look, Will, you've got to do it for me.
I said no.
Look, Marie's an old friend of the family's, huh?
I don't care whose old friend she is. Every time you want to get out of a date, I'm stuck.
Look, she's crazy about orchestra leaders, and besides, she's got plenty of money. You know, she's liable to even sponsor a day for you at Carnegie Hall or the Hollywood Bowl or something, huh?
Well, maybe.
Supposing my father does close us down here. She's liable to stake us to another nightclub. What do you say, huh, Will?
All right, you win.
Oh, you're a swell guy for my money.
Oh, no. It's for her money.
Will you walk this way, please?
You mean we're eating here?
Certainly. Uh-uh. You ain't eating there. I said you ain't eating here.
I ain't? I mean, I'm not?
No, you're going to be as follows, more private.
Private?
Yeah. Come along this way. This way.
Mr. Warren always have his dinners in privacy?
Certainly.
Isn't that a little strange?
No, not for him. He does a lot of strange things.
I know. He looks at people like this.
I see what you mean. This way, please. This way, please. This is it.
Is this where we're having dinner?
Yeah, the boss will be right in. Have a seat if you want to.
What are you doing?
Fixing the bed. What's it look like?
Isn't that just a little unusual?
No. Mr. Warren has his dinner here every night.
What?
Nothing.
All right. Why does Mr. Warren have his dinner here every night?
Because he's eccentric.
You mean he's...
Yeah, Mr. Warren has his troubles.
In that case, I don't want to disturb him any more than he already is, so I think I'll be going, and you tell him that I'll see him in the morning.
Oh, well, hello. You're right on time. May I take your coat?
No, thanks. I was just going. It's late, and it's been very nice being here.
Going? Why, you just got here.
Don't go. He's nice. And I think it would be very cozy if we three had dinner together.
But I already have a dinner. I couldn't stuff another one down.
Well, force yourself.
Are you kidding?
No, I'm not kidding. I mean it. I like people around me, lots of people. I wish there was a crowd here. Tell the others to come in.
Force you, sure. Pick some dillies.
Well, shall we have some dinner?
Don't come near me. Don't come near me or I'll scream.
Oh, please, Miss Lawrence.
If you take another step, I'll christen you.
Why, Miss Lawrence, I don't under...
Stand back.
Oh, please, let's...
Stand back.
You don't have to shake our champagne to make it good. It's got lots of life in it. Let's see, stand up straight a minute. Let's see.
What are you doing?
A little big, but they'll do. Good night.
Good old Moose. He thinks of everything.
Yes, doesn't he? Mr. Warren.
Oh, call me Danny, would you?
Danny, these pajamas. They're yours, aren't they?
Oh, I get it. You're afraid to stay here tonight. Well, you don't have to be afraid. Because just remember this. You won't be alone. I'm not the only one here, you know.
Are you mad? Oh!
We just come in to say goodnight.
What happened?
The poor kid is weak from lack of food. She fainted.
You men get out of here. I'll put her to bed.
If you hadn't looked at her, she'd have never fainted.
Annoying.
All right, break it up, break it up. Moose, go fix Carol some breakfast.
Carol?
I mean Miss Lawrence. I'm going to see if she's awake.
You heard what the boss said?
Yeah, for you to get the breakfast.
He did, didn't he?
Yeah.
Come in closer, boys, while I explain. Now, you heard what the boss said.
Kitchen! And prepare a breakfast fit for a princess!
Say so in the first place.
So you look silly but cute.
Well, I... That is...
Moose is fixing a little breakfast.
I'll be out as soon as I get dressed.
Fine.
Oh, Mr. Warren, I mean Danny, I remember I fainted, and when I woke up, I was dressed in this. How did...
Don't let her worry you. Marie put you to bed. You know, you were really out on your feet last night.
I guess I was. But I feel fine today.
That's well.
It's just wonderful.
You're the most incompetent, inefficient, useless, and... Tell me, why didn't you stop him from opening that club tonight?
I did the best I could.
Well, it wasn't good enough.
Well, your idea didn't work out so well either.
Huh?
Does that mean anything to you?
Carol Lawrence, no. Oh, Slater, huh? Well, that I can understand. But inefficiency, I can't understand. I'll show you how to handle a thing like this. I'll go over there tonight and serve the notice myself.
Well, what do you want me to do? Don't answer that question.
Why don't you mugs be careful?
Oh, that's all right, Mo. It wasn't their fault. I wasn't looking where I was going. Oh, that's nothing. It's just...
So you tried to put the finger on Danny, eh?
You, the kid we trusted like she was our own sister. Maybe better, even.
Oh, no. I was at first, but not...
Wait a minute. What goes?
She's got an attachment for Danny.
I knew it. I could see it was love at first sight.
Quiet, Featherbrain. It ain't that kind of an attachment. She's a process server.
A what?
Oh, please let me explain. I did start out to serve Danny with this paper, but after you were so kind to me and I met Danny, I just couldn't.
Sounds good.
Oh, you've got to believe me. I wouldn't do anything to hurt Danny. Here, I'll prove it to you. Now are you convinced?
You stack up okay with us.
She sure does.
I'll say.
Oh, you don't know how happy this makes me. I could kiss all of you.
Recede. Line forms on the right.
Right.
Oh. Say, this looks like a swell game. Can I play too? Boys, I'm still worried about those process servers. You better check all the doors.
Yeah, we'll check all the doors, Danny. Come on, fella.
Yeah. Okay, thanks. You look a little excited, Carol.
I guess maybe I am a little.
Well, sit down and relax. Everyone gets the opening night jitters, you know. I'll never forget that first night.
Oh, brother.
What?
Oh, brother. It's the title of my song. I think they want me for a rehearsal. I'll see you later. Yes, later.
Opening night jitters.
How's the romance coming along?
With Will?
You like him, don't you?
Oh, I think he's so handsome, I'm going to build a new nightclub for him.
Oh, now, Marie.
Oh, don't worry, you'll see Will. He's going to just build it across the street.
Oh, that'll be cozy, yes.
Boss, the head waiter says he's got to have more waiters. The crowd's way beyond his expectations.
Well, how do you like that? We got a big crowd, now we don't have enough waiters to handle them.
Well, there must be some way.
Hey, wait a minute, I've got it. Put Mo, Larry, and Curly in as waiters.
Mo, Larry, and Curly, but they couldn't
have. Oh, I know what you mean, but what else can we do?
It looks like you're a success.
Oh, I hope so. Of course, the evening's still young if my father doesn't close us down.
Oh, Danny, I know what you've tried to prove, kicking around in nightclubs as an entertainer. You wanted to show your dad you could stand on your own two feet and be somebody without any help from him. Well, now you've made your point, perhaps things up.
Well, I would, Marie, but the way he feels about this venture here, I don't think he'd ever listen to me.
Well, you just leave him to me. I'll bring him here if I have to put him in a straitjacket.
You're wonderful.
Now, Larry, you take 9 and 10. Mo, 11 and 12. Curly, 14 and 15. Now go to your stations.
Oh.
Hal!
Well, Moose, good evening.
See you.
How's the chance for good kids?
Oh, this is wonderful. Shall we dance first?
I don't mind.
Oh, isn't the music divine? What's the idea? Who are you?
I'm the fellow you asked to dance.
How dare you?
Oh, superstitious, eh?
Well, of all the...
Presenting Connie Boswell.
Don't know.
the way the blues walked in and met me. If he stays away, old rocking chair gonna get me. All I do is pray the Lord above will let me walk in the sun.
In an extra potato today.
I don't like roast beef.
Oh, you don't, eh? Do you realize what a cow gives up? Do you both realize what a cow gives up just so you can have a little piece of roast beef?
I don't care what sacrifices a cow makes. Do I or don't I get roast turkey?
Now, let me put it to you another way. You have a kind face. A cow hasn't got a chance. All she lives for is just so you can have some roast beef.
Stop. You make me feel like a murderer.
Head waiter, come here.
The trouble, sir.
I demand this insolent waiter be replaced.
But what did he do, sir?
Me too. I want roast turkey. He insists I have roast beef.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. Why, you dumb flat. What's the matter with our roast beef? Bring him roast beef.
They'll have to give better service than this, or this place will close.
I should say so. We've been sitting here more than half an hour.
Waiter. It's about time you got here. Do you realize we're waiting for you?
Yeah, of course.
Let's have something to eat.
Yeah, I don't mind if I do. Thank you.
What is the meaning of this?
You asked me to have something to eat. Don't be ridiculous. John, this is so humiliating. Everybody's looking at us.
Will you take our order, or do I have to send for the manager?
All right. What do you have?
A menu.
A what?
A menu. I wanted to see what you had to eat.
I didn't eat yet.
A menu that you read from.
Oh, a menu that you read from. We have onion soup, duck a la compree, kidneys, Romanoff, and Mastellini cherries.
We can read.
Oh, sure. What an impressment. Yeah. Thank you. And thank you.
Hello, that's the same one.
It is.
Yay.
Well,
No, never mind, dear. Let's dance.
Oh, but listen to me, Louise. You can see for yourself. I got talent.
Wendy, I haven't got time. I'm watching the door so that certain people who would like to cause trouble don't get in, if you know what I mean, and I don't think you do.
I'll just listen.
Wendy, please. Good evening, sir. Enjoy yourself.
Thank you.
Now, Wendy, please, let's drop it for the time being.
Oh, but Louise.
Good evening, Miss Flinch.
Vince.
Oh.
Oh, Louise. Give this gentleman a good table.
Yes, Miss Flinch. Right this way.
And another thing, Papa Warren. My family is just as respectable as yours.
Well, of course, my dear.
You like me, don't you?
Well, certainly, Marie. But I don't like what you do.
You don't know what I do. Please, for my sake and Danny's, try and see our point of view. And for once in your life, relax. Have a few drinks. We might even be able to hand you a few laughs. Try it, won't you?
All right, I'll try.
I have to go backstage and see somebody. We'll see you later. Please have a good time.
Don't worry, my dear. I'll be all right.
Is he tall and dark and handsome? And are his eyes a baby blue? Now has he lots of dough and then some? And will he always be true to you?
Hi.
I couldn't begin to describe him, 'cause I don't know the words. The only thing I know is that he's the only one for me. And when I look in his eyes, oh brother, and when he sighs, oh brother, out of this world he takes me, out of this world into a dream, a lovely dream. I feel a sprinkle of stardust in the air, like Rip Van Winkle. Wonder is he really there, and when he gives me a kiss, oh brother, is that a kiss? Oh brother, out of my mind I'm going, out of my mind. Is that a man? Oh what a man. I know for certain there'll be no more flirting, he'll be my permanent thrill. And will I have him meet my mother? Oh brother,
look. A wise guy. Keep your eye on him, Larry. Keep your eye on him.
And will I have to meet my mother, old brother? You know that I will.
Chum?
I want to see my son.
Oh, you want to see your son? He's a process server, all right. Hi! Hey!
What? Hey, what? Stop it! Hey! Why are you...
Just a minute! Take your hands off this gentleman! I'm terribly sorry, sir. What happened? He's a process server.
Come on. Out you go.
Come on.
And don't come back. What am I saying? It's me.
Take your dirty paws off me.
Listen, I have influence. This town, I'm going to break every last one of you.
Oh, show a button on it, pal.
What's going on?
Why, these hoodlums have...
This guy got drunk inside the club and tried to break things up.
That's a lie. I tell you, it's a lie.
Stop yelling.
I'll yell if I feel like it.
See, just a noisy drunk.
Yeah, he's reeking with liquor. Come on.
You mean you're going to arrest me?
That's a very good guess. Let's go.
Wait a minute. No.
Nice work, gentlemen. I congratulate you.
Thank you.
Oh! Get inside, you hoodlum!
Hey, okay.
People, yet I found you, or should I really say, you came my way. Small world, and with so many places, yet one would do. We traveled very far, but here we are. I'm not surprised, I'm sure this had to be. For now I know I could love only you, and you could love only me. Small world, filled with millions of people. Yet I could find the heart that is tied to mine. Small world.
Small world filled with millions of people.
Yet I found you. Just one would do.
We traveled very far, but
here we are.
I'm not surprised, I'm sure this had to be. For now I know I could love only you, and you could love only.
Danny, that was wonderful.
She certainly is.
Thanks, Marie. You two certainly have it bad.
What? Oh, hello, Marie.
Danny, your father's here. I went after him. I think he's softening up.
He is? Oh, gee, that's swell, Marie. Say, it's too bad we don't have time for Moose and the boys to prepare something special for him.
Woman called Caledonia is her name. Caledonia.
love you just the same. I'll always love you, baby, 'cause Caledonia is your name. She ain't no good, son. She's bad for your morale. She'll have you doing things that ain't right, son. But see, Mama didn't know I was in love with Caledonia. So I'm going down to Caledonia's house and ask her just one more time. Caledonia! Caledonia! Or what makes your big head so hard?
I kept your name out of the papers. Wouldn't you be in fine shape if it read Daniel Warren Sr. held for disturbing the peace and resisting arrest?
I don't see anything funny about it.
Yeah, I guess it isn't funny.
You've been letting others do all the work. Now more than ever, I want that dispossessed notice served, and right away.
I'll see to it tonight.
Personally.
Tell me, when you went to your son's club, did you see this Miss Lawrence?
Yes, she's very good, too.
Well, how can you say she's very good? She probably used the dispossessed notice as a bribe so she'd get herself a job.
I'm a better judge of character than you are. I don't think she did.
Anything else?
No, thanks. Oh, say, Mo, by the way, thanks for taking care of that process server last night.
It was a pleasure, boss, a great pleasure. You know, that guy had nerve enough to say he was your father.
Oh, no.
What's the matter, boss?
Now I know why my father didn't come back to say hello last night. I don't know how many more tricks he has left, but he'll certainly use them all.
Don't worry, boss, they won't get by us. Well, gentlemen, time to... Oh, my watch, huh? Oh, I left it in the kitchen. Will you get it, Mo?
Oh, sure, sure.
Yes, Larry. What are you looking for?
A watch.
A watch?
Yeah, it went down the drainpipe.
That was Moose's watch. He'll murder us.
You better go and get it quick. I can't.
Oh, yes, you can, because you're going right down that pipe after it. Come on.
Wait a minute.
Come on, get up here. Down. Pardon me, boys. Hello? Yes. Definitely. Absolutely. Positively. Wrong number. I'll have that guy's phone taken out. Curly? Larry?
Yes?
Third dimension. Larry, how you doing?
I ain't found it yet.
Well, don't come up until you do find it.
Okay.
Hello? Who is this?
This is Curly.
Where are you?
Down the cellar.
Did you find the watch?
What watch?
See this?
What? Oh!
Larry?
Yeah?
Hurry up.
It's awful dark down here. Keep your shirt on. I can't see a thing.
Well, you better hurry up before Moose comes back.
If you think you can do any better, get down there yourself.
Quiet. I can't hear a thing. Look in the little dark corners.
What?
Why did you find my watch? It went down the drain. You put it down a drain pipe? Well, you'll get down and get it or I'll skin you alive. Come on. Easy, folks, easy. Get the wife. Get a wrench.
A wrench?
Monkey. Don't
be personal.
Get going. And when I get back, you better have to watch.
Mike,
just grab a wrench.
Get started!
Good. The watch must be caught in that trap. Come on, give me a hand. Get up there. Hup. Hup. Easy now. Got it.
Don't be impatient. No, we didn't find it yet, Moose. A little leak started in the cellar, and we had to fix that first. But listen,
Moose is on his way down here, and he's plenty sore. Curly, did you find it?
No!
Hey, Larry!
It ain't in here.
What are you guys doing in there? I gotta...
Good evening. The captain will see you.
Now, Moose?
Wendy, I haven't got time to listen now.
Oh, but Moose, please, it won't take long.
I'm watching the door.
Oh,
good evening.
Moose, please.
Good evening.
Just a minute. Have you got a reservation?
Why, no, I
thought so, outside.
I want to talk to Mr. Warren.
You and a lot of other guys. Now, serve your papers somewhere else.
Now, look here, you can't...
Give me a hat.
I'll punch you right in... Thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh, hello, O'Connor.
Hello, Moose.
When you quarrel and the teardrops start, a tender word will mend it all. Someone's faithful heart, a tender word will mend it all. Better than roses or gifts she'll tire of, tell her that she's the one you love. Why be foolish while your castles fall? A tender word will mend it all.
When you've quarreled and the teardrops start,
a tender word will mend it all. Why be foolish while your castles fall?
A tender word will mend it.
A tender word will mend it.
A tender word will mend it all.
But I told you the other night, wasn't Danny's fault, Papa Warren. The boys didn't know you were his father. They thought you were a process server. And Carol didn't know you were trying to be nice.
Doesn't make any difference. I'm going to take my son out of the entertainment business and close up that club. It's the last thing I do.
Excuse the expression, but you're being an obstinate old lady about this, so you better get up. Come on now, get out of bed.
Oh. Don't be ridiculous, Marie.
Don't you dare call me ridiculous. Go ahead, pull down the sheets.
If it weren't for your mother.
Yes, I know. You'd be my father. Now your left leg. Now your right. Now you sitting up?
Yes, I'm sitting up.
Put your clothes on. I'm coming over to get you.
I'll be ready.
Ooh.
little fond affection. That is all I'm thinking of. I have been in heaven since the day I found you. It is really heaven with my arms around you. Just a little fond affection cheers me when I'm feeling blue. Just a little love, a little affection from you. Won't you hold me just a little closer? Tell me that you love me true. When you hold me just a little closer, this is what I want from you. Just a little fond affection. That is all I'm ever dreaming of. I have been in heaven since the day I found you. It is really heaven when I find my arms around you. Just a little fond affection cheers me when I'm feeling blue. Just a little love, or just a little affection, darling, when it comes from you.
Here they are.
Thank you, girlie. Oh, you're such a dog. Looking for somebody?
Yes, Mr. Warren.
Well, you can't see him, eh?
I have something for him. Something for the show. As a matter of fact, he's waiting for it.
Yeah, what is it?
A song.
A song? What's the name of it?
I have an attachment for you, baby.
Sounds hot. I bet you that'll send him.
Oh, it will.
You wait here. I'll see if I can get Mr. Warren. Don't move. That's a coincidence.
Good evening.
Good evening. Oh. Oh.
You've been a long time serving that paper.
Oh, Mr. Bascom, I was going to call you. I don't want the job. And besides, Mr. Warren is out of town, so please go, and I'll call you.
You want to see me?
Oh, Danny.
Danny Warren?
That's right.
I have a present for you.
How did you get in here?
Just walked in the back way. As for you, young lady, the next time I give you a paper to serve, serve it.
Nice work.
I can explain.
You should have waited until the finale. You would have gotten a big laugh. Yes, a big laugh.
Danny, look who I brought.
Well, you did all right, Dad. All the time I was getting ready to open this club, you had a process server working here, ready to serve an attachment on me.
What process server?
Carol. She brought the man in here to serve the papers.
Not only did I take all the credit, I brought him in. How'd you like it?
How'd I like
now,
it?
Now, wait a minute. If Carly brought him in, then Carol had nothing to do with it.
And as far as this club is concerned, I suppose it is more fun than the utilities business, Danny.
Oh, gee, Dad, you're swell. And Marie,
yes,
you...
I know. I'm wonderful. Now, get going. Taxi? Carol?
Carol? Carol, I understand everything.
I'm not interested.
Oh, now listen, that kind of stuff is for children. Now stop acting like one, or I'll put you across my knee.
Oh, no, you won't.
Well, all right, you asked for it.
Hey, what's all this about?
Officer, there? This man is...
Is her brother, and she's my sister, and she's trying to run away from home.
They beat me, and they keep me locked up in the cold there.
We do not. We use gas.
Now, wait a minute. You go on home with your brother.
Thanks,
and
officer.
And you stop beating your sister and get going.
Put me down.
They say they're brother and sister. I say they're a couple of bad liars.
You're right, officer.
No, ma'am, and I've got talent.
Well, that doesn't make any difference as long as you can do something.
Oh, he's in Mr. Warren's office.
Come along. Wait here. Good evening.
Oh, it's you, Miss Flinch.
Finch, Mouse.
The name is Moose.
Moose, yes, I know. I have someone outside that's very clever.
Yeah? Anything for a friend of yours.
Come in, son.
Oh, him?
Yes. Come in.
Well, I would like to give an imitation of a squadron of airplanes bombing a city. They're going to take a landing now. Taking a landing. Next is pop the bottle and ginger ale comes out of it, huh? Ginger ale. I'd like to give an imitation of sawing a piece of wood. Sawing a piece of wood now. Piece of wood. Next is a motorboat starting. One of those motorboats now. Motorboat starting up. Here it is. That's the bubbles. Very cheap motorboat, Ridman. I'll get it. Excuse me. now my dad's old car. Here it is. Next is a train going up a steep hill. Going up a steep hill now. All aboard!
Tender words.